More than 700 jobs are on the line at NZ Post as the national carrier responds to a rapid drop in demand. New Zealanders now send a quarter of the mail they did 20 years ago. Tiana Wahurihanganui has more.
Demand for postal services is nowhere near as high as it used to be.
When is the last time you sent someone a letter?
Never. I've never sent anyone a letter.
I can't even remember. It's been quite a while, a long time.
But looking back a few decades, it was a different story.
The jobs are really hard to come by at the post office to be a postie.
20 years ago, New Zealanders were sending more than a billion mail items a year. That's now down to around 200 million. And with reliance on this service expected to just keep falling, NZ Post's planning to cut more than 750 jobs, a sixth of its workforce, over 5 years.
This is us responding to the fact that New Zealanders are getting more and more of their communication through online means.
Frontline workers and processing staff will be the first to take a hit, but Air 2 Union is ready to support members into new work, signing a transition agreement with the company.
We partner with MSD and a number of other training organisations. We look to set up job exposed so that other companies can express an interest in those workers.
With online shopping on the rise, there could be opportunities to redeploy staff.
Big decline in mail, growth in parcels, and we're working with our people as we go through those changes to see what opportunities come from that as well.
One of the concerns we have is that the company may move the posties into the contracting model like they use for contract couriers. They don't get annual leave, they don't get sick pay, they don't have a collective agreement.
NZ Post has already made changes to mitigate its high costs, including cutting the number of delivery services in urban centres by half and increasing the price of sending a standard letter by 30 cents to $2 from July.
A wave of change and uncertainty ahead. Tiani Wahurihanganui, One News.